Hallo, ik ben Roel. We zijn vandaag bij het hoofdkantoor van Schwalbe. Daar zijn we uitgenodigd om een kijkje te komen nemen en ook om het te mogen filmen. Ga je mee naar binnen?
We don't have the tire production here in Germany. It's based on our history and our cooperation with our South Korean manufacturing partner. Yeah, but we tried to show part of the production and what is needed for every tire in our company. So we built up this special display, which shows the development and the production of a tire from the raw materials up to the finished tire at the end. And what you can see here are the basic raw materials that you need for every compound. You have, for example, oils, you have pigments, silicates. What is really important for every tire is, for example, carbon black. And yeah, this combination together with natural rubber and together with synthetic rubber is our secret. It's the company secret how to create the perfect rubber. And as you know, we don't have only one compound. We have a lot of compounds that we use, for example, especially for road bikes, that we use, for example, especially for traveling bikes or mountain bikes, mountain bike tires. And every compound is really sophisticated and specially made for the purpose where it is needed. And actually everyone in the tire industry knows how to make a compound, but how to make a really good compound is a secret and I would say a really tough job. And we invested really a lot in machinery, in raw materials, and in new colleagues that help us now to also develop new compounds, to make compounds better, of course, and to make better what we actually still have. And actually everyone knows how to make compounds, but to put the things together is a thing of try and error. So we create a lot of new compounds, make them in the production facilities. Then they are tested, and then you are able to know if a compound is really good and makes what you want that it makes or not. So it may be that we have 100 new compounds, but just one compound will be used in the production. So this is really a tough job for the colleagues and the biggest expertise of our Korean partners as well, because they have of course all the machinery to mix up the compounds and to test it also in the facilities. What you see here is used for the production of butyl rubber for tubes, because it's very, very important to have a real clean compound for tubes. I already said it in the stock entry control that impurities, for example, is a really bad failure and mistake in every tube. So we put a lot of attention to a real clean butyl rubber for every tube. And we have up to 7 meshes which are getting less rough to have at the end a real clean butyl rubber for the tubes. And for example, the share of high quality butyl in a tube is, for example, responsible for a tube that retains the air longer in a tire, in a tube, sorry, compared to other tubes. In the next step, you see different rubber compounds. this is a pre-production. During the production process, every compound is made in the layers, as you can see here on the picture. And every colored compound, for example, is used as a puncture protection system in the tire. It's not really necessary to make it in different colors, but on the one hand, it helps the workers do not mix up it in the production process. And it's, of course, very nice to show it in a tire sample with a cup piece to show how a tire is built and what is inside a tire, because when you look at it, you just see a black thread and you don't know what is actually inside a tire. Really important thing, which is a main issue for quality, is, for example, the carcass. And for Schwalbe, for example, we use also for active line tires a really high quality carcass material. And we start with an EPI of at least 50. I don't know if everyone knows what EPI is. Or TPI, it's ends per inch or threads per inch. So it shows the how many threads are lying next to each other in 1 inch. And this, on the one hand, is explains the stability of a tire, and a really good carcass also helps a tire to run smoothly, to run good, and to reduce rolling resistance. And next to the carcass, every tire, of course, needs bead. And typically, steel beads are used, but for performance tires in road racing or mountain bike, for example, a material like aramid, for example, is used. Why it is used? It is foldable and it makes a tire very light. And as you can imagine, every bicycle tire has to be as light as possible. So this helps us, for example, to decrease the weight of a tire. Materials like the carcass or the steel, this is something that we buy from special manufacturers. But every process after that is made by ourselves in our factories. For example, the carcass has to be topped with a compound, with a rubber. And that is really necessary that every material in one tire sticks perfectly together after the vulcanization. And this is all done in our factories in Vietnam and in Indonesia. Everything is putting together on these special building drums. We have this kind of tire, it's called a green tire. And as you can see, it's completely flat. But it's almost finished. The only process or the only step now missing is the vulcanization. And this is also like we are choosing the perfect materials. The vulcanization process is a kind of company secret, because you need to have the correct temperature, you need to have the perfect time for vulcanizing a tire to get the specific performance of the rubber that you want to have. And what you need for the vulcanization is this special inner tube. It's called the airbag. It's in fact also a tube, but very strong. And in combination with the correct air pressure, you preform the tire, and it gets already the shape of a finished tire, and then it comes into the so-called in the molds. In Germany we call it Waffeleisen, and these special molds give every tire its specific design. And also these molds are made by 100% in our production facilities. Because when you order it, for example, from a Chinese manufacturer, you can be sure that any other competitor will have the same tread pattern a few months later. So yeah, we try to make really everything in our facilities by ourselves, to keep our know-how within our company, of course.